leading and being led in Salah. Many Muslims disagree about who is more worthy of being the Imam, although it is a point which the scholars of fiqh laid down many centuries ago when they said that the most worthy one to be an Imam is the one who is the best reciter of the Book of Allah. After that comes the most knowledgeable of the Sunnah. Next is the first to observe Hijrah, but if there is no migration, then the first of them to repent from sins. After all these comes the eldest, if the level of the people in all the aforementioned qualities is the same. The proof for the above stated sequence is the saying of the Prophet, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. The best in reciting the Quran should lead the people, and if they are equal in the recitation, then the most knowledgeable about the traditions of the Prophet. And if they are equal in this, then the first to perform migration. And if they are also equal in this, then the first to accept Islam. However, when a congregation already has an imam, or the imam is the owner of the house, or he is one of those in authority, then he is to be considered before others. This is due to the saying of the Prophet, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, a man does not lead a man in his territory. If there is only one follower, the sunnah is to stand on the right of the imam next to him. This is according to the hadith of Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I prayed with the Prophet at night, and I stood on his left. The Messenger of Allah, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, thereupon held me by my head from behind and placed me on his right. But if the congregation is two or more, the imam stays in front of them at the center or midpoint of the row. This is according to the hadith of Jabir and Jabbar, may Allah be pleased with them, that one of them stayed on the right side of the Messenger of Allah and the other on his left. Jabir said, then the Messenger of Allah, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, held our hands together until he made us stand behind him. However, the situation is different for women. If females pray in a group where there is no man around to be the imam, it is sunnah for the female leading the prayer to stand in the middle of them, in the same row, not stepping ahead of them, and the woman stands behind the man leading her, or behind the row of men, when she prays with a group of men. Concerning this, the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, the best rank of the females is the last one, and the worst rank of the females is the first one. One of the points which the scholars discussed is that it is not valid for someone to follow the imam from his house by hearing his voice through a microphone or radio. But it is permissible to follow the imam when one is outside the masjid if the one praying is in a row which is connected to those inside the masjid. And one may follow the imam even from the roof of the masjid or a position lower than that of the imam. One of the subjects which Muslims often ask about is praying an obligatory prayer with one who is making a voluntary one and vice versa. Both of these are allowed. For example, it is allowed to pray Isha behind an imam who is praying Taraweeh, and the opposite is also allowed, as Mu'adh used to pray with the Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, and then go to his people and lead them in prayer. The people following the imam have to emulate him by doing everything he does immediately after him. This is according to the statement of the Prophet, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, which states, the imam is made to be followed. So when he says Allahu Akbar, then you should all say it after him. When he bows, you should all bow. And when he prostrates, you should all prostrate. The Prophet, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, warned severely of competing with the imam or even preceding him by saying, does he who raises up his head before the imam not fear that Allah will turn his head to that of a donkey or turn his appearance in that of a donkey? But this threat is not directed to those who inadvertently precede the imam, as what is compulsory for him is to only return and follow the imam. It is stipulated that the imam remains silent between saying the opening Allahu Akbar and the recitation of the Fatiha in order to recite the opening invocation. It has not been established in the sunnah that the imam remains silent between the Fatiha and the surah recited after it. But the followers recite the Fatiha at any time when the imam is quiet. The imam should also be silent after ending the recitation before bowing, that is ruku'. If a person misses a salah and he wants to make it up, he recites it aloud if he is making up a prayer normally read aloud, even though it is during the daytime. An example is when one misses Fajr, waking up after its time, so prays it before Dhuhr. Similarly, he should read quietly in prayers that are normally prayed quietly, even though it is during the night. An example is when one misses Asr and prays it quietly after Maghrib. As for the voluntary prayers, it is sunnah to recite them in a soft voice, except for when there is evidence to say it aloud, for example, the Taraweeh prayer and the Eclipse prayer. One of the easy aspects of the Sharia is that the voluntary salah of a person prayed in the sitting position is considered valid, but he receives half the reward of the one who prays in a standing position. This is due to the Prophet saying, if he prays standing, it is better. And whoever prays in a sitting position has half of the reward of those who stand. And whoever prays lying down gets half the reward of those who pray sitting. But for obligatory prayers, if the person prays sitting and he is able to stand, his prayer is not valid. However, if a person prays sitting down due to a valid excuse, he receives the full reward. This is due to the Prophet, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, saying, if a man becomes sick or travels, it is written for him that which he used to do while in good health and not traveling. Another situation that might occur is for the people to pray behind the one who is in a state of ritual impurity. Such a prayer is not correct, except if the impurity is not known about until after the completion of the prayer. In this case, the prayer of the one who prayed behind the imam is valid, but it is compulsory on the imam to re-offer his salah. If the follower manages to perform the ruku' of the prayer with the imam, then he has caught the entire raka'ah, or unit of prayer. This is due to the Prophet saying, whoever makes the ruku' has caught the raka'ah.